Hi there, welcome back. I hope that you are all feeling creative because it is time for us to do what we've been working toward for the past several months now, and that is start writing your creative story. I need you to refer back to lesson five, to your notes. It was called Starting a Story Part Two. Remember that we've learned that there are three parts to a story. There's the character, there's the problem or the conflict, and there's the resolution. You are going to be writing phase one of your story over your vacation and over the next few weeks. Phase one, if you remember back, you did an assignment where you planned the different phases of your story. Let me find my note to myself. Assignment number eight, you mapped out a story, and you'll notice on that handout that it's broken down into phases. In phase one, you are going to set the stage. You're going to give the time and the place that the story happens. You're going to introduce and describe the main character and the secondary characters. You're going to help us to know your character's problem or his flaw, his internal flaw and his external conflict or problem. You're going to bring the first obstacle or complication into your main character's path, okay? Then after you're going to write phase one, and you'll see that I've attached a description of that assignment. It's kind of a grading rubric showing what I'm going to be looking for. That's called homework 10, the attached document. So you're going to be writing and submitting the first phase to me, and then we're going to go over some exercises that will prepare you to write phase two. In phase two, you're going to continue the story, bring your character through that first complication, bring in other problems and obstacles for him to face, and just move your plot line along. Phase three of your story is going to contain the crisis, the final big struggle, the moment of truth where your main character overcomes his flaw, learns his lesson, resolves his conflict. And then phase four is going to be the resolution, where you see how life played out afterwards for the main character, after he's resolved his conflict. It's kind of the aftermath that lets the reader down easy after the action of the story is finished. Okay, so you're going to be putting this story together in those four distinct phases. But you're going to write them one at a time and submit them to me one at a time. So we're going to work through this process gradually and not all at once. I think that you're probably more ready to do this than you think. You need to refer back to your notes, though. You need to pull out your plot skeleton where you planned the story that you were going to write. You need to refer back to the lesson five notes where the different phases of the story are defined so that you know where to stop phase one. This is just the beginning. This is sort of the, once upon a time, there was a girl named Sally who lived in the big dark woods and her mother was very sick. Okay, that's your very, very basic version of what these first maybe three pages of your story are going to do. They're going to tell us when, where, who else, and what's the problem. Okay, if you think of it as those five things, it's the time and the place, some description. I want to be able to picture where I am, where these characters are, the time and the place, picture the characters themselves, and the other people and stuff in the surrounding the character, and then move your character into the first problem, the first stage of encountering the problem or the conflict in the story. So this is a setting the stage. It's important to understand you are not, this is not going to have an ending. This is the first piece of one continuous story that you're going to be writing in four separate stages, okay? So this doesn't have a beginning, middle, and an end. This is the beginning, okay? Look over the attachments, look over your own plans. Think about the things that we've learned. Every single activity you have done so far has been leading up to this moment and the next several assignments that you're going to be doing. Okay? If you have any questions on writing phase one, let me know, but be sure you go back over your stuff that you've kept. This is to be the story that you outlined and submitted a skeleton for, and it's going to follow the criteria on the attachment to this email, and the purpose is to write just phase one of the story. Okay? Now I'm going to give you until January 6th, if you can, if you have a very busy Christmas holiday and you're traveling or whatever, January 13th at the very latest to get this first stage of the story in. So be sure that you email me if you have questions about it, okay? But I think you have, if you look back in your notebook or back in your emails on your computer, I think you will see that you have everything that you need to write phase one of your story. Okay, this is where it gets interesting. I am excited to read your ideas and to see how these stories unfold. We will also, if you want to, try to arrange for you guys to be able to read each other's. If you're willing to share with each other, I could attach and email these stories out to one another. Maybe you could get some feedback from each other, or just get each other's responses to your stories as you write them. It always makes it a little more interesting to know somebody is reading what you write. But I will not do that without asking you first. So don't worry, I'm not going to go scattering your writing far and wide. Okay, have a wonderful Christmas and happy writing.